Hey, what's up, drone pros? Today we have the Mavic Air 2, and is this the last drone you're ever gonna need? Today we're gonna be comparing it to the Mavic Mini, Mavic Air, Mavic 2 Pro. We already shot some really incredible video comparisons, and to be honest, I was completely blown away. So let's get started. Alright guys, let's cut to the chase. The first thing we're going to talk about is price. The Mavic 2 Pro comes in at $1,599, the Mavic Air 2 comes in at $799, the Mavic Air at $599, and the Mavic Mini at $399. So the new Mavic Air 2 fills the price gap between the Mavic Pro 2 and the Mavic Air. But how does the quality compare? Should you upgrade from another drone? Should you downgrade from another drone? Stick around till the end to find out. The results might just surprise you. Okay guys, next up is weight and size. In my opinion, I'm used to flying 38 pound drones, so all these drones are super small, super portable, but some are a little bit smaller than others. The Mavic Pro 2 weighs in at 2 pounds, the Air 2 at 1.26 pounds, the Mavic Air at 0.95 pounds, and the Mavic Mini at 0.55 pounds. So if you're gonna go for portability, the Mavic Mini wins for sure, but there's gonna be a trade-off for camera quality, as well as being able to fly in wind, and it doesn't have sensors and a bunch of other features. But as far as the build material of the Mavic Air 2, I would say it's not quite as strong as the Mavic 2 Pro, but it's definitely way stronger than the Mavic Mini. Okay, next up is camera sensor size. The Mavic 2 Pro features the 1-inch Hasselblad sensor, the Mavic Air 2 features the 1/2-inch sensor, and the Mavic Air and Mini both feature the 1/2/3-inch sensor. Now, usually the larger sensor is always gonna win in camera quality and low light. But DJI is doing something crazy with the 1/2-inch sensor in the Mavic Air 2. We're gonna talk about that at the end of the video. Okay, next up is obstacle avoidance sensors. The Mavic 2 Pro has front, bottom, side, and top sensors. The Mavic Air 2 has front and back, but it's equipped with the new 3.0 APAS system. This is supposed to help it be able to maneuver around objects better. The Mavic Air has front and back sensors, but the Mini has zero, so keep that in mind. Next up is controller comparison. This is the biggest change we've seen in a long time with the Mavic line. It's a completely redesigned controller where you mount the phone on top of the controller and the antennas are internal. And to be honest, I love this new design. It's way less awkward to use and it's way more ergonomic than the standard Mavic controller. All right, next up is a real-world battery length flight test. Okay, so just so you know, all the drones were fully charged and they were hovered in place for the entire flight. And there was about 1 to 5 mph wind gust during the flights. Okay, so the Mavic 2 Pro came in at 20 minutes and 5 seconds. The Mavic Air 2 came in at 25 minutes and 8 seconds. The Mavic Air came in at 13 minutes, 29 seconds. And the Mavic Mini came in at 22 minutes. So that's some really impressive flight time from the Mavic Mini, but the Mavic Air 2 wins out on this one. Next up is a real-world top speed test. Mavic 2 Pro came in at 43.4 miles per hour, the Mavic Air 2 came in at 40.9 miles per hour, the Mavic Air came in at 33.5 miles per hour, and the Mavic Mini came in at 27.5 miles per hour. So all in all, the Mavic 2 Pro and the Mavic Air 2 are very similar speeds. Okay guys, next up is real world flight distance. That's how far you can see the drone before you have to return the home and make it back safely. So for this test, we drove way out into the desert, totally away from any kind of Wi-Fi signals, anything like that that might affect this test. Okay, so the Mavic Pro 2 max distance before returning to home was 13,168 feet. The Mavic Air 2 max distance was a whopping 18,504 feet. The Mavic Air max distance was 10,464 feet. And the Mavic Mini max distance was 9,946 feet. So the Mavic Air 2 just totally dominated in this category. Also, keep in mind the max range documented by DJI for both the Mavic Pro and the Mavic Air 2 is around 11 miles, but it's literally impossible to fly that far and have enough battery to make it back safely. But if you're in more of a kind of a congested area with digital traffic and stuff, then the stronger signal will help you cut through some of that digital chatter. So that's a big win for the Mavic Air 2 in this category. Okay, next up is obstacle avoidance. For this test, my plan was to follow my son around on his bike in the park with trees. We did some test flights following him around, but I felt like the DJI drones were just not suited for this purpose yet. They had a difficult time tracking and kind of getting around objects, and I was really worried they were gonna crash into tree branches. So as far as fast stuff around trees and things, I don't recommend it, but as far as walking, I had some okay results. So for the Mavic 2 Pro, the drone followed me around the trees pretty good. Kind of had a close call with the tree, but we didn't hit it. Then I started running and it did a really good job keeping up with me. And when I reached the tunnel, it lowered down to come inside, but it stopped and it wouldn't go any further because it has to be a certain height in order for it to track. The Mavic Air 2 did a great job following me around the trees. I even ran the tree fast to see if it could keep up, and it did quite a good job circling around the tree without hitting anything. It also did a good job keeping up as I ran down the hill to the tunnel, and the Air was the only drone that was able to come down into the tunnel and then follow me through. It did lose track when I got really dark, so I adjusted exposure, but it was able to follow me through the tunnel. I was really impressed with it. The Mavic Air followed me pretty good around the first tree, but it nearly ran to the second tree. It was about 6 inches away. I had to run up and grab it really quick, but it did track me really well when I was running, but once I got to the tunnel, it stopped because it would not go down low enough to enter the tunnel. So overall, the Mavic Air 2 is a great improvement with the obstacle avoidance. I also noticed that it allows you to initiate a track from a lower altitude than the Mavic Pro 2 or the Mavic Air. Though I wouldn't use it for any high-speed tracking around high trees or anything like that. But if you're out in the open, that's a totally different story. Next, we tested how it tracks a fast-moving object in open terrain. For this test, we head out to the desert and chase my Subaru around. The Mavic 2 Pro did an absolute amazing job and held a lock solid track and was able to go into sport mode to circle the moving vehicle and get some incredible shots. The Mavic Air 2 also did a really good job. You can also go into sport mode as well. It also seemed that it moved forward and backwards as it kind of tracked the subject as if it was analyzing more data or something. I'm not quite sure the best way to put it. The Mavic Air also did a pretty decent job tracking, though it did lose track occasionally, but when it did track, it actually got some really cool shots. We tried to use tracking for the Mavic Mini on this test, but it would not track a moving subject. So overall, I feel like the Mavic 2 Air and the Mavic Pro 2 are very, very similar. I might just give a very slight edge to the Mavic 2 Pro. I feel like it can move around even faster than the Mavic 2 Air and tracked amazingly well. So I'd call it a tie for this one. All right, next up was the funnest test. This is the unscientific leaf blower test. The first thing I did is I held the leaf blower up to my wind meter from about 4 feet away, and I clocked it at about 50 to 60 miles per hour. All right, first up is the Mavic 2 Pro.
Position. He's just flipping around. Full throttle. Oh, shoot. Whoa. That's awesome.
So compared to the maximum wind resistance data that DJI gives us, I think this drone did amazingly well for being blasted with 50 to 60 mile an hour winds. I felt that definitely the Mavic 2 Pro probably was the most solid, followed by the Mavic Air 2, then the Mavic Air, and then of course the Mavic Mini was just getting thrashed around, thrown in circles. But it held its position, which really impressed me no matter what I threw at it. Something really cool about the Mavic Air 2 is that it has the ability to shoot 42 megapixel photos. And when it takes a photo, it gives you a DNG RAW file as well as the JPEG file. RAW means you have a lot more data to work with, so you can totally customize your exposure, fix things, bring out contrast, bring up the shadows. Okay, so what I did is I took a photo from the exact same spot in the air with all the drones facing towards this mountain, and we're gonna zoom in 600% and see which one is the sharpest and has the most detail. As you can see, they're not very far off from each other, but the Mavic 2 wins in my opinion with the sharpest image and a little bit more detail than the other options. We also shot a quick low light test. I feel like the Mavic 2 Pro with its bigger sensor and larger aperture was able to get a little bit more lighting compared to the other cameras. We also shot a quick video low light test, but we had an issue with one of the cameras. But all in all, as far as I can see, low light is not a super huge strength for any of these drones. All right, now is the big moment for the side-by-side video comparison. So for this test, I decided to film into the direct sun so we could find out which camera had the best dynamic range. We matched the settings on all the drones, then we matched exposure of the sun. Check out that Mavic Air 2. I was totally blown away. You can see the perfectly exposed sky. You can also see my face with plenty of detail compared to the other cameras. So this, in my mind, is a complete game changer. While flying this drone, I noticed myself gravitating to using the HDR mode for pretty much all of my shots. Now, there's one caveat, and they might change this with a future update, but you cannot manually shoot in HDR. So that means that if you tilt to the ground or you look up to the sky, your exposure is going to change. But as far as raw footage is concerned, I think it looks incredible. Okay, so here's an example where I filmed from the Mavic Air 2 with and without HDR. As you can see, the HDR pulls out this amazing HDR dynamic range, and it's really just incredible. The Mavic 2 Pro or the other drones can't even touch it. But also the non-HDR mode, I feel like, has a lot of data there, and it looks good as well. All right, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this comparison video. It was really fun to make, really fun to test out the Mavic Air 2. I'm really, really excited about it. But the question is, what drone should you buy? Should you upgrade? Should you downgrade? And if you're just getting started, should you jump straight up to the Mavic Air 2 or go for a cheaper drone? To be straight up honest, after spending 3 days shooting with this drone, I think my go-to drone that I'm gonna pull out of my bag is gonna be the Mavic Air 2. Mainly because of the range, the HDR video, and the crazy 48 megapixel raw photos. I've been around cameras for a long time, and to be honest, this is a pretty monumental breakthrough that DJI has come through with in the video world. Now don't get me wrong, if you already own a Mavic 2 Pro, I own one too, it's a freaking incredible drone. Don't feel bad or guilty, it still will do pretty much everything that you need it to do. But the Mavic Air has some really cool features that really stand out. But if you have the Mavic Air or the Mavic Mini, then I definitely recommend going for this upgrade, going for the Mavic Air 2. Also, the price is really quite incredible for what it is. It's definitely kind of a consumer, kind of a drone, but I put it up there really, really close to the Mavic 2 Pro. Well, hopefully you guys really enjoyed this video, and you know, with drone technology, this is getting better and better and better, but there's always skills that you can learn to become a better drone pilot, create amazing cinematic images, amazing cinematic video, and I've created a course called Cinematic Drone Secrets that helps you do just that. It's the complete crash course for the drone pilot who wants to master cinematic drone shots no matter what drone you own. And I'm offering a crazy discount right now on this video if you click the link in the description or the link at the end of this video. And if you want to see more videos like this one, hit the subscribe button and then the bell to be notified when we post our next one. All right, thank you guys so much, and we'll see you guys later.